Tonight, a new crackdown on the text message scams responsible for conning Aussies out of millions of dollars each year. Personal information stolen, life savings lost. And it all starts with this sound.
The first message was a Medicare branded message saying that I had been a close contact to the Omicron variant and it was to get a free rat test sent out.
Juggling four sick kids, Storm Tate handed over her credit card details for the supposed delivery fee, later finding out the text was a scam. But the scammers weren't done yet.
About a week later, I got a message in my original thread of messages from NAB that I got date back to 2017. Someone claiming to be from the fraud department and were going to contact me about some recent activity on my account.
Then the killer blow, a call from a NAB-listed number telling her she'd been hacked and needed to shift all her money to new accounts away from the scammers. That too was a scam.
All up, we've lost close to $60,000 and the bank recovered $74.87. It's been devastating and just mentally draining.
Storm is far from alone. Last year, Aussies lost around $10 million to SMS scams. All up, 67,000 scams were reported. Fake COVID tests, lottery wins, delivery trackers, missed voicemails, dodgy tax returns, subscription renewals, threats of fines, and even jail. The list goes on and on and on.
We announced the other day we'd blocked literally 185 texts in the last 3 months and more than 200 million calls in the last 12 months.
Now authorities are cracking down.
Telecommunications operators will have the obligation to identify, trace and block scam texts.
With $250,000 fines for telcos that don't comply.
It does have an impact and this should make things better for Australian consumers.
I think it's fantastic, but I also think, like, how was this not done ages ago? Like, these scams have been going on for such a long time. If these were already implemented, then we wouldn't have even received these messages and I wouldn't even be in this situation.
Oh, that's horrible. John Stanton is the CEO of Communication Alliance, who helped put together the new scam text rules, and he joins us now. John, Storm's story is horrifying. Why did it take so long?
We started working on this in 2019 and we initially focused on scam phone calls because at the time that was 85% of the problem. And we got an enforceable code registered then, and since then we've managed to block around 600 million scam calls and prevent them getting to Australians. You know, we're blocking about a million a day at the moment. What's happened, and that's reduced scam calls by about 50%. But what it's also done is encourage the criminals to focus more on SMS, which is why we started work shortly after the first code to try and put these rules in place.
So will these new laws stop us getting these scam texts?
I don't think we'll eradicate the problem 100%. I can't think of a category of white-collar crime that's ever really been wiped out. But it will, I think, significantly reduce the volume of scams getting to Australians. The other important part of the equation is consumer education and getting people to be more aware of the risks and what to look for and, you know, avoid falling for the traps.
Well, some of the scams are so sophisticated and there seems to be never ending supply of them, you know, like the courier, the post office, the tax department. Like, how do we stop ourselves from getting duped?
Yeah, you're right. It's very hard to stop this altogether because it's a numbers game. You know, if you can send millions of messages, you need only a tiny percentage of people to fall for the ruse and you've got a profitable criminal business. People need to be aware that if anything looks like it might be a scam, or you can't absolutely identify that it's from a provider that, you know, you have an association with, just ignore it. You know, if it asks you to click a link, think about that three times and then don't do it. You can always contact the provider that's relevant to you and see whether they sent you the message. But 99 times out of 100, if you think something's a scam, it is.
But I feel like things have changed. Like, I don't even think some of these ever even look like scams. Like, let's be honest, all of us, if not haven't been scammed, have almost been scammed, because when you get told you've got a parcel that they're tracking that's on its way, you often do have a parcel that's being tracked on its way. So it's so elaborate. Like, have you yourself ever been scammed?
I got very close, actually, and I absolutely kicked myself when I realised that I was about to fall into the trap. And you're right, many of these messages these days are very sophisticated. They look very professional. And you know, as you say, sometimes they match your particular circumstances. And it's not hard at all to fall for it. I agree.
Was it a romance scam, John?
No. For some reason, I haven't been in receipt of any of those.
Oh, not personal, John.
Not much romance either. But yeah.
How close were you to sending some money to the Nigerian prince?
He said he really liked me.
John, thanks for joining us. Let's hope this does work and does put an end to it.
A pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Poor John sounds like he wants a love scam.
I know.
Oh, that's it.
Should we send him one?
I don't know. Is that the right thing to do?
No, it's not.
I got something recently and I'm trying to figure out if it's... I wouldn't mind you guys helping me out. A few months ago. Hi, name. You have a call booked in today with one of our team. Follow here to confirm. Am I clicking on this or not, team? What am I doing?
I suggest not.
What's the giveaway?
I don't know, name. I know it's a tricky one, isn't it?
It is,
What about for you, though? Are you going to take the job at Target that you got?
Yeah, I've been headhunted by Target the last couple of weeks.
What apparently, department?
I don't know. Hoping haberdashery. But I don't know. But, I mean, I just immediately delete. But these are getting really
like
elaborate.
The bank's calling you from... Like, it's not the bank, but when the scams are calling you from a number that's like the bank number, what hope have you got to ever know if it's
when it's
real
in
or
the
not?
Thread of things...
Yeah, the body of text messages you've received. We've got no chance.
Well, we do now with this new plan. Hopefully it puts an end to it.